What's up, guys? It's Riantium here, and today we are back in Skyrim. That's right, you guys, and oh snap, it's gonna be an awesome freaking day. But first, if you guys haven't done so already, be sure to follow me on all social medias and check out my website. Links are down there in the description. So guys, welcome back, and happy Sunday, everybody. So today, if you guys haven't seen the previous mod showcases, I talked about how all of the voting that went through on the first week of mod showcases that I've done, I'm so excited and so happy that you guys enjoyed the mod showcases and voted for the mods that we're going to show this week. So if you're new to the channel and you know you're coming for the house showcases and stuff like that, feel free to stay tuned throughout the weeks because there's going to be more mod showcases on weapons, armor, you name it. There's a mod showcase for it, guys. So without further ado, let's get into it today. So today we're taking a look at this right here. Now, I know what some of you are saying, you know, this is two orc houses in the same kind of mod showcase weekend, and you're absolutely right, but one of them was a little bit more, you know, it was a little bit more minimalistic, a little bit more simple. This one, however, is made by the same person, I believe it's made by the same person, who did the Orc Longhouse mod, the first orc home that I did a showcase on. And I gotta say, this is by far one of my favorite mods that I've seen. It's probably gonna be up there with my top 10, which I'll probably end up doing a video on, my top 10 favorite homes. But let's go and take that out of my hands, and we need to get a little bit of a view as to where this place is sitting. But before I show you that, let me show you exactly where we're at. So, Orcish Hut right here. We have Ancestor Glade, Peak Shade Tower, as well as Ancient's Ascent, Bloom Chill Passage, and Pine Watch. Now, the closest hold you're going to want to find is Falkreath, but I found if you teleport to, like, one of these places, it's very easy to find because it pops up as the little black symbol like this one on your map. Very easy to find. But let's first off go ahead and get a little bit of an overview of this house and what it's looking over. So it is indeed an Orcish hut, but it's sitting on one of the prettiest spots that I've seen. It's right under this gigantic mountain, but it's the view that it's looking at, which is the best part. So let's go ahead and come up here and I'll show you what exactly we're looking at. Look at this. Look at this. You're right over the treetops. You got the view of the mountains. You got the view of the sunrise and probably the sun's actually... That's rising and that's setting in the west. Wait, why is it right? Why is... Okay, something is very wrong. Something is very wrong. But just a beautiful spot. Beautifully, beautifully placed inside of nature. But enough ogling over that. Let's go ahead and break it down, shall we? Original Riantium style. So outside, looks like we have our wood chopping block right down beneath the house, which is very cool to see. And you'll notice there's smoke coming out of it, and I'll show you why here in a moment. But we have our tanning rack right here, as well as our anvil and smithing storage for all of the stuff that you could possibly need to store. And then if you come down below, there's a little bit of a farm down here, so you can grow your wheat and all sorts of that stuff. You got some currants, you got yourself some cabbages, but it looks like some of it is not growable, excuse me. It doesn't look like some of it is harvestable. Activate gardening equipment, okay, never mind. So you can actually just click that and it'll harvest the wheat, the leeks, the cabbage, and the carrots. Which is pretty badass, I gotta say. Kind of a nifty thing. We have an iron ore vein right at the front of the house. Pretty cool to see. But I think it's time we go ahead and go inside, guys, and show you exactly what this home looks like. And here we are, inside of the Orc Hut. Now, one of my favorite parts about this home, because I wanted to go ahead and come inside here to see what it would look like, is as soon as you walk inside of here, it's pitch black. It is dark as hell. Kind of had to turn my brightness up to get inside of here, but the reason being is because you can turn the candles on and off and change the lighting. So if you want to tell spooky ghost stories around the fire in the middle of the room, you can absolutely do that. But you can also relight the candles and make it a little bit more welcoming, a little bit more inviting. Now, in typical orc style, you know, you should have the little slits in the tent-like structure, but this is the reason why it's actually smoky outside. You can unlight, or you can distinguish and light the fire the same way that you do with the candles. Now, I don't exactly know how you can distinguish the fire, but it does not start lit. You actually need to put firewood inside of it, hence why you have a wood chopping block outside. Now, it's kind of cool to see this light coming in, but I don't foresee it, like, there's not a spot where it's coming from. But let's go and check this out, shall we? So we have a nice little table over here. Do a little bit of drinking, a little bit of studying the war map for you and your clan. Have a nice big bench to sit down right here. Kind of cool to see. And then I love these little jars that are long here. Look at this. We got herbs and spices. We got alcohol storage right there. We got more candles. A little bit more storage in these little baskets like there. And then I love this bed. Look at that. You got a book kind of cracked open. It's kind of like a back bed, which is kind of cool. You can just kind of spread out however you want to. Nice little planters right above your bed. Cool little statue of Malekith. And you received Malekith's boon for your sacrifice. And it hurt you a little bit. Okay. So that's interesting. Malekith's boon. Okay, so boon of Malekith. Fortify two-handed for 20%. Nice. Very, very cool. So you can sleep on that bed. You got clothing storage right there. Jewelry storage right there. Book storage for the bookworms of Skyrim. Very cool to see. Clothing storage. Bows. That's kind of a cool display. Look at that. Got a hunting bow and an imperial bow. Very cool. A hunting bow and a longbow. Very, very cool. You have knife storage, because you know how the orcs like to use their knives. You got arrows, large weapons. Looks like a key holder right there. So cool. I love all of the freaking decor, dude. It looks so nice. Looks so nice. But the whole entire thing just gets tied together with the fire in the middle and the hanging candles. So I do believe that's everything that this home has to offer, guys. It's one of the smaller homes, you know, but for those of you that want to roleplay as an orc, you know, and have, you know, a much smaller place to come home to, that's a little bit more detailed than one of the last orc homes that I showed, but still packs the same punch, you know, with the charm and stuff like that. Plus, you're in a great location for hunting. Kind of a neat spot to be in. But, like I said, I believe that's everything that this home has to offer. So, guys, I very much hope you enjoyed today's little mod showcase on the Orcish Hut. And if you did, make sure you guys hit that like button. No more smashing it. Just give it a little bit of a love tap. And if you guys haven't done so already, be sure to follow me on all social medias and check out my website. Links are down there in the description. And, guys, I will see you in the next video.